Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint. In one of my previous videos, I had created and used the whiteboard animation effect in PowerPoint. And in this video, I'll be showing you how you can also create this kind of stuff in PowerPoint. Let me show you what I had created.
Colors are everywhere, from our favorite shoes and clothes to the wonders of nature and outer space. Colors were invented around 40,000 years ago, and today, color is perhaps something we take for granted. With one simple click, we have thousands of colors at our disposal. But then why do we always get confused while choosing the right color scheme for our PowerPoint slide? We usually face dilemma while choosing the right background color, font color, or the color of other objects. And undoubtedly, getting your colors right will make your presentations instantly more watchable. So in this video, I will make that task easy for you, where I will discuss some really cool websites through which you can easily choose an attractive color scheme.
So guys, this effect looks very much professional and substitutes the need to buy expensive softwares like videoscribe to create the whiteboard animations. No doubt it demands more hard work and skill to create such an effect in PowerPoint, and we cannot create it that much powerful as we can create in other dedicated whiteboard animation softwares, but definitely it serves the purpose to create basic whiteboard animations. This is a complete full-fledged tutorial to create whiteboard animation effect in PowerPoint. Here, I will explain you every aspect of creating a whiteboard animation video, and after watching this video, you will be easily able to create such a video by yourself for almost any of the topics that you want. I will be dividing the tutorial into two parts. In this first video, I will teach you how to arrange elements required for creating a whiteboard animation. And in my next video, I will be teaching you the most common whiteboard animations which you can use for any desired topic that you wish to present to your audience. First of all, let me give you a brief intro about the whiteboard animation. It's the process of which an author physically draws and records an illustrated story using a whiteboard and marker pens. The animation frequently are aided with narration by script. These kinds of animations definitely provide to give your marketing strategy a boost and helps to strengthen your customer base. So the first thing which you require is a script. What do you want to animate? Is it about the sales strategy of your business? Or is it about the summary of the last year's performance of your business? It can be about anything relatable, but you must ready a script before you can actually start animating it. The next step is to record that script. You can either record your voice in external softwares like Adobe Audition or softwares like Audacity, which is absolutely free, and then insert that voice in PowerPoint. However, the easier option is to record the narration in PowerPoint itself. I have already uploaded a separate video regarding how to record the narration in PowerPoint, where I have explained it in detail, and you can find the link of the same in the YouTube show notes below. So once you have written and recorded the script, now we can begin with the actual part of this tutorial, that is the whiteboard animation process. See, first of all, you need some elements to create this effect. And the list is as follows. Images of hand at different positions and the vector icon images. Images of hand at different positions means the image of hand writing with a marker, with a pen, hand with the eraser, etc. You can find these kinds of images easily on Google. Sometimes you may get an image with a transparent background, but some images are with background like this image has a blue background. So what I will do is, I will remove the background in PowerPoint. Insert the image in PowerPoint, go to the Format tab and then hit Remove Background. Selecting the areas to keep and the areas to remove, so now the image can be used for the animation process. You can also click your own images of hand at different position and then using the same process, remove its background in PowerPoint. However, I have already made a collection of all these images and you can download it from the description box below. Next comes the vector icon images. Now this is an important part of this tutorial. you need to download the vector images in SVG format in order to use that image for the whiteboard animation. There is a very awesome website for this named flaticon.com, which offers a variety of vector icon images. You need to just search for the desired image, download it, and insert it in your PowerPoint slide. Now the question is, why do we need to download the image in SVG format and not any other format like JPEG or PNG, which are easily available? The reason being, when I right click this SVG image, click on group and then ungroup, click OK here and then again click on ungroup, you can see that each and every part of the image gets separated from each other. So this becomes very useful when I want to make these kinds of animation where I want the image to appear in parts. Alright, so this was all about the elements that are required to create a whiteboard animation effect, and in my next video, I'll be showing you some common animation techniques which you can use to create a full-fledged whiteboard animation video on almost any topic. These are the common techniques and can be used by everyone. So stay tuned for my upcoming videos. That's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.